What's up, guys? Today's junk is going to be the toolkit that I take around with me everywhere I go when I'm operating the landscaping business. So the primary function of this toolkit is to fix and repair in the field any of my lawn mowing equipment. I have a 36-inch Skag walk behind, as well as the typical blower and trimmer, and various other equipment that if I'm out and I'm at a job site, I'm going to need to have tools on hand just in case something goes down. And this kit has gotten me out of trouble a couple of times. So I keep the whole thing in the back of my van, out of the elements. And the van is a complete disaster at the moment. I need to clean it out. And that's what made me want to make this video as I'm going through that stuff. So I keep the whole thing in a crate type of setup. This is made by Rigid. And this is a good setup that I've been using because it connects and it latches onto other Rigid toolboxes. And I got this right from Home Depot, and I forget how much this was, but I want to say it was around $15 to $20. And you can use any old crate or toolbox that you have, but I got this one specifically because I'm already committed to the Rigid system with their parts organizers. I have a number of those, and I keep them, screws, nails, small parts, and this is just one more piece of that kit now at this point. So this toolkit that you see here has been evolving ever since I started the business. And you know, your lawnmower goes down, you're going to want to fix it. So this speeds up productivity and time, and it saves you a lot of money if you're even just a little handy, and you can fix some minor things yourself in the lawn mowing business. So the lawnmower that I have has some grease points, so I have a grease gun here. I try to do that regularly. Next, I have some PB Blaster. This is just, you know, for stuck bolts and stuff like that. Haven't needed this too much on newer equipment, but as your equipment might get a little older and, you know, do those odd repairs that you only do every so often, this could help with freeing up some stuck fasteners. I'm not quite sure what this is called, but you get this with every chainsaw and other kinds of equipment. I've been calling this a scrunch. I'm not quite sure. It's a screwdriver and you know, a wrench on the top. This has been good for spark plugs and stuff like that, like you would on a chainsaw. I've used this a couple times to do a tune-up on the fly on my blower. For whatever reason, one day my blower wasn't working right, so I swung by a store, got a tune-up kit, and then fixed it up brand new in the parking lot. Took all of 5 minutes. Air filter, spark plug, you get the idea. I have some tire repair kits. Now, this is plug kits that I've been collecting over the years. So, Slime brand and some other stuff, but I need to consolidate these into one small container. This is not the kind of thing where you need a whole lot of redundancy, so I don't know why I have two of these, so I need to break them down into smaller containers. I also have a 12-volt Slime tire inflator. This is not the kind of thing you're going to want to use on truck tires or van tires, because it would just take so long, and this little guy is not really equipped to handle that kind of load. But this would work great for a mower tire or anything like that, a sulky tire. I also have a couple of socket sets. I have a quarter-inch drive from Home Depot and a 3/8 drive in here. And the 3/8 drive also comes with a quarter-inch driver for different bits and stuff like that. So I have screwdrivers, I have Torx drivers, all that included in this kit, as well as the quarter-inch. And this has been the most commonly used thing in this whole kit. And the cases are very big and heavy. I gotta get some socket rails or something and kind of consolidate these down even more, so it's more room in this. And the last thing I just got is this has gotta be consolidated big time, is this wrench roll. Now, let me switch cameras around and show you what I got here. So this is by no means a professional grade wrench set, but I was looking for something that was cost effective and affordable and practical with many different sizes. So I found this on Amazon, and this was about $32, and they actually remind me of the old Craftsman raised panel, the old school wrenches. And they're not the best quality, but it got great reviews. So I pulled the trigger and got these guys. And it goes from in quarter inch all the way up to 1 inch. And it doesn't seem to be skipping any quarter. 5/16, 3/8, 7/16. Yeah, it looks like it goes no skipping all the way up to 1 inch. And then on the metric side, I got 8 to 24, but it does skip 9, 16, 20, 22, and 23. So there's a couple more sizes that they skip. I'm just hoping that this is kind of an emergency kit. If anything happens, I pull this out, kind of fix my equipment. So, like I said, I really need to go through this. It's a small kit, but it's not designed to rebuild any engines. This is just to get me back moving to finish the job and, kind of figure out what to do after that. If this kit can't fix it in the field, chances are I need to load the mower up back on the trailer and get it back to the shop anyway. So that's that. What I need to do, though, is consolidate this, like I mentioned, to kind of make it take up less space, get rid of the big bulky cases for the socket sets, and maybe do something with this wrench roll, because the wrenches do kind of fall out. So I got to figure that out. What I would like to do is add to this a cordless inflator. I do have the 12-volt inflator, which is fine, but let's say the mower is all the way on the back of the property. I'm going to have to push it to the front if it gets a flat. Now, I do have a bicycle pump that I keep in the van as well, and that's somewhere in the van, and I need to reorganize that. So the bicycle pump could replace the cordless inflator, but if you're like me, you just want a new tool anyway. So I'm considering between the Milwaukee M12 and the DeWalt 20-volt. That's kind of where I am at. I also have some Ryobi 18-volt tools and batteries, so that's on my radar, but between those three, I'm probably going to leave that as my last option. Just it's Ryobi. If I can get the Milwaukee or the DeWalt, I'm going to lean towards that. All right, guys, that's that for this week, this week's video and the toolkit. If you have any suggestions of what I should be carrying for landscaping, lawn mowing, leave a comment down below. And, if you like this video, please click like, share, subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram @GettingJunkDone. Thanks for watching.